liquid to the warm milk. And this liquid is called rennet. And rennet is a natural enzyme which causes the milk to curdle. So when we add the rennet to the warm milk, the milk is going to be thick like a pudding. Añadimos este líquido, se llama cuajo, es una enzima para cuajar la leche. Y cuando la leche está cuajada, necesitamos acortar la leche. Con este cuchillas especiales. So when the milk is thick, like a pudding, we need to cut the milk. And we use two of these knives and they are rotating through the thick milk and cut the milk into very small pieces. And then, after about 30 minutes of cutting the thick milk, the milk will separate into two parts. Into a liquid part of the milk called the whey, and into a solid part of the milk, the curds. And we use the curds to make the cheese of. Después 30 minutos de cortar la leche se separa en dos partes. Una parte líquido se llama suero. Y contiene muchas vitaminas y proteínas y lo damos a los animales, es muy sano. Y una parte sólida, la cuajara y lo que es el queso. So then, we push the solid parts, the curds, into molds like this. And then you get a nice shape of the cheese. And we place all the molds under a pressing machine for about 2 hours. Prensamos la cuajara en moldes durante 2 horas. So after those 2 hours under the press, we place the cheeses in a salt water bath and they have to stay there for 24 hours. And the salt water gives the cheese its natural rind and of course a more salty flavor. Después ponemos los quesos en un baño de sal durante 24 horas. Es por la corteza natural y más sabor. Then out of the salt water, we take them out. They have to dry for a while. And then we plastify them. They get this yellow plastic coating around them to protect them against drying out and against mildew. And then they have to age. And they have to age for at least 6 weeks. So you have to wait for 6 weeks and then you can eat the cheese. Después del baño de sal, plastificamos los quesos. Es para protegerlos contra el moho y no que se sequen. Y los quesos tienen que madurar durante 6 semanas. Y después de las 6 semanas tenemos un queso muy joven. Y después 4 meses es un queso semi-curado. Y después 8 meses es un queso viejo. So if you let the cheese age longer than those 6 weeks, it will become an older cheese. So it will become harder and saltier and drier. And if you like that kind of cheese, we have this special one, and this cheese has aged for 3 years. So that's quite old. And this one only 6 weeks, this one 3 years. So you can imagine that this one is really hard and salty and dry. And it's a little bit like Parmesan, only that from Holland. Si le gusta el queso muy viejo, tenemos este. Es un queso de 3 años. Muy duro, muy seco. Es un poco como Parmesan. Parmesan de Holanda. And we also have this kind of cheese. They look like a sausage, but it's cheese and it's smoked cheese. So they have a really nice smoky flavor. Este queso es queso ahumado. Es muy rico también. So now I like to show you how we cut our cheeses. I have a nice piece of the Gouda cheese and we use this knife to cut the cheese with. Esta cuchilla es para cortar queso en lonchas. It's very easy. All you need to give a little. You want to try cheese? If you're on the first cheese row, you're lucky, eh? You can have a piece.
Yep.
Yes, here you are. You too. Here you are, sir. And this one is the very young one, eh? Only 6 weeks old.